Hey everyone, welcome back to another episode of Technically You, where we take a deep dive, literally today, into the world of geothermal energy.
Today we're cranking up the heat beneath our feet. We're talking about geothermal energy, what it is, how it works, and why it might just be the future of clean power.
So let's start with the basics, especially for our listeners wondering what geothermal energy is. Well, geothermal energy is heat that comes from within the earth. The word geothermal itself literally means earth heat.
That's right. And this energy is harnessed from underground reservoirs of hot water, steam, and heated rocks. It's been used for centuries, from Roman bathhouses to modern power stations.
Okay, so how do we turn that underground heat into usable electricity?
It starts with drilling, just like oil or gas, but instead of fuel, we're tapping into hot water or steam. That steam spins a turbine connected to a generator, producing electricity.
There are also binary cycle systems where the geothermal fluid doesn't even touch the turbine. It heats a separate liquid with a lower boiling point to generate steam. Now, that is super efficient.
Okay, let's talk about infrastructure. What does a geothermal plant need?
You'll need a production well, a reinjection well, and a power station. The heated water or steam is drawn up, energy is extracted, and the cooled water is sent back underground to be reheated.
Yes, closed-loop systems are also popular for residential heating and cooling, especially in geothermal heat pumps.
So why is geothermal such a big deal? What are its benefits?
Let's count the ways. It's renewable, low emission, incredibly reliable, like 24/7 power, and has a tiny land footprint compared to solar or wind.
And the operating costs are low after installation. Once it's running, it's super efficient and clean.
Here's a kicker. Geothermal can hit capacity factors of 90% or more. That's better than solar or wind, which are intermittent.
Wow, that is because geothermal, not dependent on the weather, sun or snow, underneath and inside the earth is still hot.
But of course, it's not all sunshine and lava, right?
Exactly. The challenges include high upfront costs, geographic limitations, you can't just drill anywhere, and the potential for induced seismicity if not managed properly.
And let's not forget the risk of resource depletion if reservoirs aren't managed sustainably.
So where are the hotspots, literally? Where does geothermal work best?
The best geothermal locations are along tectonic plate boundaries like Iceland, the Philippines, Indonesia, New Zealand, and parts of the U.S., especially California and Nevada.
But even countries without volcanoes are getting creative with enhanced geothermal systems, EGS, which artificially stimulate heat flow deep underground.
All right, let's talk about the future. What's next for geothermal energy?
We're looking at breakthroughs in EGS, lower-cost drilling tech, and hybrid systems where geothermal is paired with other renewables. Plus, geothermal energy storage and direct heating for urban areas.
Yes, and big names like Google and Fervo Energy are investing in geothermal, showing that this isn't some niche. It's mainstream energy in the making.
Okay, before we start to wrap things up, let's dig a bit deeper into EGS. As we stated earlier, traditional geothermal energy needs naturally occurring underground heat and water reservoirs, right? But what if the earth's hot, but there's no water or porous rock to tap into?
Enter enhanced geothermal systems, or EGS for short. It's like the DIY version of geothermal. You make the hot spring without the spring.
Exactly. EGS involves drilling deep into hot, dry rock, then injecting water to create an artificial reservoir. The injected water absorbs the heat, then it's brought back to the surface to produce steam and generate electricity.
So basically, we're engineering our own geothermal resources. Hot rock is everywhere beneath the Earth's surface. We just need the right tools to use it.
And that's what makes EGS such a big deal. Traditional geothermal is limited to tectonic hotspots, but EGS could expand geothermal access globally, even in places that don't have volcanoes or geysers.
That means any country could potentially harness clean, reliable, round-the-clock geothermal power, that's a game changer for energy independence.
Exactly. Now, let's explain, how does EGS work step by step? One, drill deep. A well is drilled several kilometers into the Earth's crust, reaching hot but dry rock. Two, fracture the rock. High-pressure fluid is injected to create small cracks. This process is called hydraulic stimulation, kind of like fracking, but used to create pathways for heat exchange, not to extract oil or gas. Three, inject water. Cold water is then pumped into the reservoir, where it circulates and gets heated by the surrounding rock. Four, extract steam or hot water. The now hot fluid is brought back to the surface and used to drive turbines to generate electricity. Five, re-inject and repeat. The cooled water is re-injected into the system to keep the cycle going.
Thanks for that explanation. Now I'll cover some of the benefits of EGS. First, there are massive expansion potential. EGS could unlock up to 100 plus gigawatts of clean power in the U.S. alone. Second, it is clean and renewable. Like traditional geothermal, it produces low emissions and minimal land use. And third, it is also scalable and location agnostic. No need to live on a volcano. EGS can work in more locations than traditional geothermal.
Of course, EGS isn't magic. Just like geothermal, it still has hurdles. Drilling is expensive, and working at those depths isn't easy. And there are concerns about induced seismicity. That's mini earthquakes caused by the fracturing process.
But new AI-assisted drilling, real-time seismic monitoring, and advanced fluid dynamics are helping make EGS safer and more viable.
Okay, let's talk about some real-world examples of EGS. Fervo Energy, backed by Google, recently demonstrated EGS-powered data centers. Also, the U.S. Department of Energy's FORGE project, Frontier Observatory for Research in Geothermal Energy, is developing cutting-edge EGS technologies in Utah. And finally, Iceland and Germany are also investing heavily in EGS as part of their renewable energy strategies.
So there you have it. Geothermal is powerful, clean, reliable, and largely untapped. It may not be flashy, but it's heating up in a big way.
Remember, the Earth's been holding on to this energy for billions of years. It's about time we leverage and make good use of it.
Okay, listeners, thanks for tuning in to Technically You. If you liked today's episode, be sure to subscribe, drop a review, and share it with your favorite renewable energy nerd.
And as always, stay curious, stay cool, or in this case, warm. We'll catch you on the next one.